अब जो नेक्स्ट प्रॉब्लम है इसको हम बोलते हैं वाटर जग प्रॉब्लम. द नेक्स्ट प्रॉब्लम इज द वाटर जग प्रॉब्लम. एंड व्हाट इज अ वाटर जग प्रॉब्लम? विल बी हैविंग टू जग्स हियर. सो अज्यूमिंग दैट दिस इज द फर्स्ट जग. हाउ टू ड्रॉ इट? आई गेस दिस वे इट विल बी बेटर. सो दिस इज द फर्स्ट जग विच इज हैविंग सम वाटर एंड दिस इज द सेकेंड जग. And as you can see here, the size of this jug is bigger than the size of this jug. The first jug is having a size of 4 liters and the second jug is having a size of 3 liters. Now, there are no markings on these jugs. There are no markings that how many liters of water is inside this jug and how many liters of water is inside this jug. Now, the first variation is that we want to see, can you write something which will tell how can you find that 1 liter of water in 3 liter jug. 1 liter of water in 3 liter jug. That means इसका मतलब क्या है कि अब आपके पास ये दो jugs हैं. This is the first jug, this is the second jug. इन jugs के अंदर you can fill water. Okay, आप इनके अंदर water fill कर सकते हैं. अब water fill करने के लिए there is no limitations. आप कितना भी water utilize कर सकते हैं. Now, the thing is, there is no marking on these jugs and you cannot measure water. But only you know is that this jug is of 4 liter and this jug is of 3 liter. Now, your aim is to fill this 3 liter jug with 1 liter of water. Can you do it? See if you can do it. This is the first variation. The second variation is like this. Now, the capacity of the first jug is 5 liter, assuming that this is the first jug. Let me draw a jug in a different manner this time. So this is the first jug. Okay, I should have drawn them like this. Yeah, I don't know. So this is the first jug and this is the second jug. The second variation of the same problem. Okay, now this first jug is of 5 liters and second jug is of 3 liters. 5 liter and 3 liter jug. Now, in the 5 liter and 3 liter jug, can you fill 4 liters of water, 4 liter of water in 5 liter jug, 5 liter jug? Again, there is no markings are on the jug, number of, the amount of water you can take, there is no limitation. The only thing is this jug can have 5 liters of water in total and this jug can have 3 liters of water in total. Okay. And again, there are more variations to these problems that there can be different capacities here. And there's one more variation in this way. You can see that this is the first jug and this is the second jug. And here saying the first jug, it is having some Q liters of water. And second jug is having some P liters of water. Now they will be asking you that can you find X liters of water in the Q liter jug or in the P liter jug. So you will be asking you some questions based on this and they will be saying you that this P liter jug is having the capacity which is less than the Q liter jug. Can you find X liter water in P or Q liter jug? Can you find this much capacity of waters or not? And so this is showing the state. So initially this is the problem. Okay, now you understand the problem. Now, can you find some steps to reach from the final initial location to the final goal or initial goal to the final goal? Okay, so let me do one thing. Let me draw this one. Okay, let me continue with this one only. Now, the first problem is this one and let us try to see can we solve the first problem where in the first problem they are saying that the first jug is of 4 liters and second jug is of 3 liters. Okay, and initially I'm showing them showing how many liters of water in this jug and how many liters of water in this jug with this pair, that is x comma y, where x is representing this is x liter of water in the first jug and y is representing this y liters of water in the second jug. Okay, so initially both these jugs are having 0, 0. That means both of them are having 0, 0 liters of water. And we want to reach to a final goal where there will be 1 liter of water in the 3 liter jug. and you can transfer water from this jug, obviously, that is, I guess, that is intuitive and obvious. Now what you can do is, from here, you can fill 4 liters of water in the first jug. That means you are going to fill this complete jug entirely, the 4 liters of water here, and this 3 liter water jug will be entirely empty. Now from this one, what you can do is, you can transfer some water from the 4 liter jug to the 3 liter jug, and the amount of water which you can transfer, that will be equal to 3 liters at maximum. So you will be having 1 liter of water in the first jug and 3 liters of water in the second jug from here to here. That means this jug will now be containing only 1 liter of water, and this jug will be completely filled with 3 liters of water. And now I guess the problem is very simple. In the next step, you take all the water out from this 3 liter jug, and this 3 liter jug will become empty. That means it is containing 0 liters of water. And then you put all this 1 liter of water in the 3 liter jug. So it will be containing 0,1. Okay, now for this particular case again, this is the initial state. Now, these are representing the middle states or the other states, and this is representing the final state. Final state. So again, the same definition, we have capital S, we have capital S, we'll be having a small s, we'll be having O, and we'll be having G. Where this is representing the goal configuration. This is the state A, state B, state C, state D, state E. Apart of this, there are a lot more different states which are possible. For example, from here you could have taken 0,3, or you could have taken 4,0, or you could have taken 4,3, or you could have taken different things. Again, from here there are different paths which are possible. Okay, and there may be some paths where they are matching. For example, here if you take 4 liters of water out of this, then it will come 0,3. That means it will go to this state. Okay, so there may be multiple states which are possible. So which this is represented by capital S. This is a set of all the states which are possible. Now this small s is representing the initial state. So initial state is represented by A. G is representing the final state, which is represented by E. And O is representing the operator. But here the operators will be that you will be able to transfer this water here, or you will be able to transfer from water from here to here. So this is how you will be able to transfer different locations. Okay, so again you can see there are more than one paths which are possible. There is one path which is possible here, there is one path which is possible here, there is one path which is possible here, there is one path which is possible here. From here to here there are one path, from here to here there will be one path. So there are so many different nodes which are possible, and there will be so many different paths which can be achievable from this one. Okay, and the operators are fill the jug, pour the water in the another jug, and pour the water on the first starting jug. Okay, and in the same way, if the second problem is, can you fill 4 liters of water in the 5 liter jug? Can you solve this problem? How will you solve? So to solve this problem, initially the goal configuration is, initial configuration is 0,0, and the final configuration which you want is 4,0. Can you solve this problem? Try to see if you can solve this problem. So what you can do is, you can take this one, you can fill 0,3. That means you are going to take this empty and you can fill 3 liters of water in this jug. Now in the next case, you will be transferring all these 3 liters of water into the first jug. So it is 3,0. Now this jug is containing 3 liters of water, this jug is containing 0 liters of water. Now from here, what you can do is, you can also fill this jug with 3 liters of water. So we'll be reaching to the next configuration, we'll be having 3,3. Both the jugs are having 3 liters of water. And then you can fill this jug from water from here. That means you'll be transferring some water from here. Obviously it is containing 3 liters. There's a 2 liter space which is empty. So if you're going to transfer water from here to here, that means you will be transferring 2 liters of water. So there is 1 liter of water which will be available into this jug. So you'll be having 5,1. Now with the help of this 5,1, now you can clearly see, I know we have 1 liter water here. So you are going to empty this 5 liter jug. So it will be having configuration 0,1. Then you are going to transfer this 0 liters of water into this 1 liter of water here. And the next configuration is 1,0. Now that means the 5 liter jug is containing 1 liter of water and 3 liter jug is containing 0 liters of water. Now from here you can fill this 3 liter jug. So it will be 1,3. Again you can transfer this 3 liters of water in this jug. So it will be 4,0. So again you reached the desired goal configuration that this jug should be containing 4 liters of water. I guess this is very interesting, right? So I may be making it boring, but I think this is very interesting. This kind of problems, they take some practice before starting the subject also. Some cases, this type of problem should always be there in the syllabus. Okay, now again in the same way we have this problem which is Q and P. That means there is a Q liter of water here and there is a P liter of water in the second jug. Now again you can apply different operators on this so that you will be able to transfer some water from here to some kind of amount of water here. You may be able to have some kind of amount of water here, or you may want to have some amount of water in the P liter jug. And to solve this problem, again there is a multiple methods which are possible. Okay, so you can apply different operators here. You can also solve this problem mathematically. That means you can represent the capacity of some jug with some variables, the capacity of the second jug with some variables, and to reach to a goal state you may be able to perform the operations which is addition and subtraction, that is plus and minus operations. Okay, so for example, I think that will not be good for us to waste time on that one, because that is that giving the solution is not our goal, but still I can give you the solution if you want. But giving the solution is not our goal. Our goal is to understand what is the state space. So again you can understand what is the state space in this particular example. There's an initial state, and there's a final state, and there are some intermediate states, and there may be so many different intermediate states which are possible, and there is some operators, like here you can apply the operators as plus and minus, that is adding some water into sub jug or subtracting some water from that particular jug. And this is a water jug problem. Now we have more problems here which we can take. So in the next video let us discuss about some more problems to represent state space. So I think you understand what is state space. So just do one thing, let me just take one more example, that will be a final example to represent the state space, and then we'll be seeing how we are going to solve these problems with the searching algorithms. Okay.